Doing our coronavirus coverage. Hundreds of people are testing positive for COVID daily. Lots of them end up in the hospital, but many are fighting off this virus from their own home. So what's the best way to curb those COVID symptoms and heal quick? Emily Bloom talked to the professionals to gain some insight and advice.
Nia, there are certainly some things that people can do to help themselves out if they've already caught COVID, but in terms of getting better, it comes down to isolation and time.
Oftentimes when I'm seeing patients regarding multiple illnesses, including COVID, they kind of want to know what they can take.
Less might actually be more.
The reality is there are some things that can be helpful, but there's a tendency to kind of overdo what people want to put in their bodies.
Our bodies are built to fight viruses, including COVID, and we don't want to interfere with that process too much. For those who are at a slightly higher risk, you can monitor your blood pressure and your oxygen. A standard oxygen level in most adults is between 95 and 100.
So if one of these oxygen monitors shows it going lower and continuing to go lower, that would be a time to consider getting evaluated.
Beyond that, there are a few more ways you can practice self-care while on the mend. Make sure that you actually do have COVID, either through an at-home test or at a clinic. Isolate for 10 days and make sure you have good airflow within your home. Hydrate and drink plenty of fluid. Many COVID symptoms cause you to lose fluids, and get as much nutrition as you can handle. You can take Tylenol and ibuprofen to ease the discomfort of your symptoms if necessary. And finally, time and rest. Listen to your body. And while you're taking it easy in isolation, consider your mental health as well.
Isolating physically and not isolating socially. So, you know, people who get COVID and are stuck at 10 days at home in a room by themselves, they really have a hard time emotionally.
This is the time to take advantage of your electronics to stay connected mentally.
And if your symptoms are progressively getting worse rather than getting better, that's when it's time to get professional help. As you've likely heard before, prevention is key, and that's particularly important with this virus. Reporting live in Spokane, Emily Bloom, 4 News Now.